Now, your 13 First Alert weather forecast.
Welcome back. It's 11 minutes after 6, and as the old adage goes, red sky at night, sailor's delight. Red sky in the morning, sailors take warning. This was sent to us for a weather snapshot this week by Donna in Stanley. Of course, it depicts that orange, red sort of sky. Now, that old adage is a result of where systems come from, whether it's from the west or whether it's from the east. Well, I guess it would be going further towards the east, hence red sky at night, sailor's delight. But otherwise, again, if you want to submit your photos to our weather snapshot segment, feel free to submit them to weau.com/weather and may find one of your photos showcased on our weather snapshot segment. Showers continue to push further towards the northeast and giving way to mainly cloudy sky across western Wisconsin. However, a few breaks in those clouds starting to develop. As far as how much we got in terms of moisture, this is our totals before midnight. Of course, some of these showers were after midnight as well, hence why we have further towards the southwest those higher amounts. Winona, for example, over an inch. Meanwhile, in Eau Claire, about 0.2 inches, but looking at our rain gauge at about 3 o'clock this morning, well, that's where we had about 0.2 inches of moisture. Otherwise, for the next couple of days, today, I'm not really expecting much in the way of rain, save for the I-90 corridor later on this evening. But then we have a pretty good chance at more widespread soaking rain throughout the day tomorrow, and those chances then dwindle as we progress into the weekend. Temperatures this morning, a little bit warmer as a result of some of that cloud cover hanging around. 52 degrees right now in Eau Claire, 51 in La Crosse, with winds primarily out of the west, anywhere from about 5 to 15 miles per hour, expected to pick up more as we get into the latter half of the morning and afternoon. We'll have a few intervals of clouds and sun throughout the day, breezy conditions out of the west, but later on tonight, as mentioned, around the I-90 corridor, could have just a stray shower. Our best chances arrive around daybreak tomorrow, and we'll keep those showers, again, more of a prolonged steady rain throughout the day. Could have a few rumbles of thunder associated with that as well. Right around midnight, those showers then clear out and give way to a little bit of cloud cover to start us off Friday morning. Going to look very similar to today as we do get in on more sunshine into Friday afternoon, just not quite as much of a breeze as we are expecting for today. Temperatures in the mid-60s for today, going to be a pretty mild one, slightly above average before later on tonight falling mostly to the mid-40s. Again, staying dry through the first half of the overnight before those shower chances arrive by daybreak. That will keep us on the cooler side, being that we'll have that cloud cover hanging around through most of the day before that higher solar angle gives us temperatures near 70-degree mark on Friday, as will be the case in the Chippewa Valley as well. Saturday does bring us a slight chance at showers again for the fishing opener before drying things out on Sunday and Monday. Temperatures approaching the 70-degree mark. Another chance at a few storms heading our way on Tuesday. Now for a Sunshine Award, Carla Lundin would like to nominate Stacy Brown and says Stacy is a director of the G.E. Bleskasek Family and Memorial Library in Bloomer. She reached out looking for support in finding resources, increasing collaboration in the Bloomer community in support of people who are unsheltered. She met people coming into the library who were homeless and wanted to provide better support and resources for them so they could find a safe place to live. Now, if you'd like to nominate someone, send us an email or head over to our website at weau.com.